And I'm going to show you the results of a project that we have done for the Spanish Ministry of Education. And we try to solve some current problems with respect to the educational innovation. Is that in most of the innovation, educational innovation experiences, the teachers don't know what is the level of innovation that they are doing, and and in most of the times of the experiences, they don't know what other people, other teachers are doing in the same innovation area. So we try to solve these two problems. And so the aims of the project were the inclusion of indicators of educational innovation, and to provide the classification and search criteria of good practices in educational innovation. In this sense, with respect to the title of the presentation of this work, we are worried about the educational innovative experiences and their application. It's very important because most of the times it's important the innovation is doing for a very specific area, and it's important to apply to the other thematics. And so we focus, because of the type of call of the project, we did the project for university context. So we think that there is a relation between these three aspects, because the experiences, the educational innovative experiences, should be applied to other areas, and it improves the contents of the university context, in the university context, and the university push to the teachers to do educational innovation. So we think a knowledge management system should be the base of this knowledge spiral. So we are in this work, we fix indicators in this sense, for the educational innovative experiences, for the application, and specifically for the university context. For we divide in two steps, in stages. It's indicator to obtain the indicators. So we focus in the innovation indicators in general, not only for education, in specifically for educational innovation indicators, and more specific for university. In that sense, we did several studies. In this first time, for innovation indicators, we studied the classical studies like Oslo Guide, or the studies done by the OECD, etc. And we also studied journals related with the innovation in general, and also specific for the education. So also we obtained the indicators from an expert group with several experts from different countries. And more specifically for university, we studied the keywords that the teachers include in the papers. And we studied a big number of papers in which we studied what keywords they include in the papers. And so also we studied the practices done by several groups with respect to educational innovation. From these studies, we have obtained the categories in the sense of educational innovation value chain. I mean that we studied the motivation to do the innovation, the innovation characteristics, the development of experiences, the results, that's important, and also the dissemination. These are the aspects that we studied in each of these steps. So the second part of this study of indicators focusing in the university is by means of a questionnaire that we prepared and we passed for 600 university teachers. And I include completely they answer 228, so, but it's a good number of results. And again, we studied from this, we tried to obtain results or answers from this questionnaire in all of these categories. So, but this questionnaire was done from a different experience. So I mean that to prepare this questionnaire, we previously applied a method that we call 2P. I mean, I explain what I mean. The method 2P is based in two parts. The 1P is focused on speaker. Well, it's P because of ponente in Spanish, okay? Well, in English, one S would be. Well, we obtained the indicators from experts of different areas by means of micro conferences. So this is, we prepared a seminar in Zaragoza, specifically. And from the micro conferences, we obtained some results. The second P is focused on the attendance. Well, in Spanish, it's participante. And so is the first P is ponente, and the second P is participante. So, and it's focused on the attendance by means of groups of university teachers. In this sense, we studied by means of micro conferences. We studied the innovation indicators in general because people from companies also talked in the conferences. Also in the education, about the educational innovation indicators and also the university, specifically the university. And so after that, we done some groups of teachers, university teachers, and from these discussions, by means of moderators and chairs of the session, they proposed some questions to the groups from the conclusions that we have obtained from the micro conferences. So. All of the conclusions, the final conclusions, were the results of the two parts, of the experts and from the teachers also. So we prepared a conceptual map from these experiences, and also the questionnaire that we passed to the 600 universities. This is. A general view of the conceptual map is, of course, from this section we obtain a lot of subsections. So, but I spend a lot of time if I go in real time to see. And so, I only saw a view. So, from the results of the questionnaire, I only show you two. Aspects. One of them is about the barriers that the teachers find when they want to apply or to include an innovation in their education. So the answers about that is the most the highest percentage corresponds to the lack of indicators. Most of the teachers say that they don't know what how to know what is innovation in education, because they find some necessities, and so they do some experiences, but they don't know if what they are doing is in a level first or is very innovative. So this is the first one. And the second one is the effort, because they have to, of course, it's, include a big effort from the teachers and also from the students when they want to include an innovation. So the third one is the scan of external recognition, and most of them is from the outside the university. Most of the university are including currently are including some experience or calls for projects or seminars or something similar. But for example, the ministry still don't recognize this work yet. We hope it will change sometime. And in the very similar or equal percentage is the scant support of the resources to support this kind of innovation. So well, the other two are the absence of specific training in because most of the people have to know or to learn how to do it by themselves. And so in this sense, it's curious, well, not curious, it's normal that the first support comes from the students. Of course, if you want to do an innovation in education and you have the opposition of the students, you cannot do anything. So I think teachers recognize that the students do an effort to help the teachers. The second one is the cloud computing, is because they find a lot of technologic resources free and in internet and so on. And the third one is the experience of the own teacher, and also and here is also the support of the other teachers, because they help themselves to do the innovation. And well, the last one is the institutional support, but it's not very low. Well, it's not, of course. And well, in this sense, after, well, I only showed some results, and this is the support, the technological support for this work. Because first of all, we studied the indicators, and now we include these indicators in a technological in a repository, in order to search, to classify all of the good practices with respect to these indicators, and also to provide a way to find the good practices depending on the indicators that we need. This is the ministry, the project. And so we use the technologies Thesora. So here, in the very, so here is the search of the technology is based on the this. Okay, so one moment. For example, in the repository, we select some categories. For example, in activity, if I select theoretical classes, and also I want to know what they are doing about web 2.0, and also I want to obtain the results with respect to the motivation of the students and the personalization of the learning personalization, So if I fix these four choices, I obtain four resources. So, and it's classified, the results of the search are classified depending on the and my choices. So, and here is the resources of study is one paper, and the resources of the experiences. Well, I'm sorry, I didn't say that we included here in the repository papers from four conferences, from four and so in the papers are included the conferences. And so we included the papers from the conferences, and we classified these papers with respect to the indicators that we have prepared previously. So in this, with this search, I obtained these results. So, and also, okay, all of the possibilities that this tool offer is that I can do the search by means of the activity, well, theoretical classes, laboratory, individual work, teamwork, tutories, and so on, or with respect to methods and techniques like collaborative learning or online learning, so on. And also with respect to the results, for example, active participation in the, or to make easy the self-learning. And, but here, for example, the type of the good practice is if it's a development or an study or an experience or is innovation or research. Well, and so, and the type of financial support, if it comes from a company or from a national call or international call, so. And also, these are the four four conferences from which we have included the papers in this first part, okay? The idea is included more papers from other conferences. And so I also can do the search from the degree or a course in a degree or a country or institution, from if it's from the University of Zaragoza or a Polytechnic of Madrid, and so. So these are all of the possibilities that I can choose to do the search. And so when I do a search and I obtain a result, I can obtain what is the paper and a description of the paper, and also some other papers related with this, because this is the generic organization of this paper. Well, we obtain all of the information about this paper, okay? So this is the one of the results of the search. And also a good, very good tool of this repository is that if I obtain, for example, this, four papers, I do a search, okay? I choose some aspects. For example, I want to know what they are doing in Madrid, in the Polytechnic of Madrid, with respect to the teamwork and in the first course of electrical engineering, for example. I choose these options and I obtain the papers related with us. And with these papers, I can generate a portfolio. A portfolio is an editable file in Word, and I can obtain all of these papers in the same file, and I can edit and change everything to work for my work, okay? for my job. And so it's a very, very good facility. And so, and with conclusions, and so we have obtained the methodological instrument based on indicators to classify innovative education good practices. It's all of the studies and the procedures that that we have done to obtain the indicators. And so also we have obtained the technological ecosystem for sharing and finding out the good practices, of course, related with the previous indicators that we have fixed. And we guarantee the sustainability and transferability of this this work, because, well, we have done that, this with some specific conference and with respect to the university, but of course all of the work is completely transferable to other areas or to other purposes. And so thank you very much for your attendance.